Henry, Gordon and James were shut up for several days. At last, the Fat Controller opened the shed.
Ah, now then, I hope you're sorry and understand you're not so important after all. Thomas, Edward and Percy have worked the line very nicely. Now they need a change, and I will let you out if you promise to be good. Now, will you?
Yes, sir. We will.
Yes, sir. We will.
Yes, sir. We will. That's right. But please remember, this no shunting nonsense must stop.
And the Fat Controller told Edward, Thomas and Percy that they could go and play on the branch line for a few days. They ran off happily and found Annie and Clarabel at the junction. The two coaches were so pleased to see Thomas again, and he took them out for a run at once. Edward and Percy played with the trucks and pushed them into their proper sidings. The trucks made a terrible fuss. They went, oh, 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 stop, 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 stop. But the two engines laughed and went on shunting till the trucks were tidily arranged. Next, Edward took some empty trucks to the quarry and Percy was left alone. Percy didn't mind that a bit. He liked watching trains and being cheeky to the engines. He would make noises at them as they went by. Gordon, Henry and James got very cross. After a while, he took some trucks over the main line to another siding. When they were tidy, he ran onto the main line again and waited for the signalman to set the points so that he could cross back to the yard. Edward had warned Percy, "Look, be careful, Percy, on the main line. Whistle to tell the signalman that you're there." But Percy didn't remember to whistle, and the signalman was so busy, he forgot Percy. Bells rang in the signal box. The man answered, saying the line was clear, and set the signals for the next train. Percy waited and waited. The points were still against him. He looked along the main line and saw something that made him go... For rushing straight towards him was Gordon with the express. Gordon went. His driver shut off steam and applied the brakes. Percy's driver turned on full steam. Back, Percy, back! But Percy's wheels wouldn't turn quickly. Gordon was coming so fast that it seemed he couldn't stop. Percy just shut his eyes and waited for the crash. His driver and fireman jumped out. Gordon yelled, "Oh, oh, get out of my way, get out of my way!" Oh. Percy opened his eyes. Gordon had stopped with Percy's buffers a few inches from his own. Percy was very, very frightened. He began to move backwards.
I won't stay here. I'll run away. I won't stay here. I'll run away. I won't stay here. I'll run away.
He was soon clear of the station and running as fast as he could. He whistled through Edward's station and he ran right up Gordon's Hill without stopping. He was getting tired and wanted to stop, but he couldn't. He had no driver to shut off steam and to apply the brakes.
Oh dear, oh dear. I shall have to run till my wheels wear out. I want to stop. I want to stop. I want to stop.
Just then, he passed another signal box, and the signalman called out,
I know just what you want, little Percy.
He set the points, and Percy puffed wearily onto a nice, empty siding. And at the end of the siding was a big bank of earth. Percy was too tired now to care where he went.
I want to stop. I want to stop. I want to stop. I want to stop.
Oh, I have stopped.
Yes, the big bank of earth had stopped Percy. His bunker was buried in it. The workmen came to dig him out.
Never mind, Percy. You'll feel better after a drink.
Presently, Gordon arrived.
Oh, well done, Percy. You know, you started so quickly that you stopped a nasty accident.
Oh, I'm sorry I was cheeky, Gordon. You were clever to stop.
Percy now works in the yard and finds coaches for the trains. He's still cheeky. He's that sort of engine. But he's always most careful when he goes on the main line.